This is a Samsung A15 5G and the screen is broken. Let's fix it. 5 years ago, I purchased this screen because I knew I was going to fix this phone. Here we have the new screen. Make sure to purchase this screen with the frame. It's only going to be like $5 to $10 difference, but it's going to save you a lot of time and it's going to look a lot much better. So a few things that we're gonna use to fix this one is a plastic prying tools, we're gonna use a Phillips screwdriver, and also maybe a few razor blades. If you're afraid to use razor blade, just can use the plastic pry tools. Let's do it. Here is a closer look of the damage on this screen. We're gonna start this repair by removing the back cover of this phone. For this, I'm gonna lay down my phone on this hot plate. If you don't have this type of equipment, you can use a hairdryer or a heat gun. It will work just fine. Now that the phone is hot, we're gonna proceed to remove the back cover. I'm gonna help myself with a razor blade. If you're afraid to damage your phone because it's the first time you're doing this, you can use a pry tool, a guitar pick, and many other tools that will not scratch your phone. I've been doing this forever, so I use this tool and I make sure to not damage the phone. After I just get a little bit into the back, I squish in the plastic tools just like so. This is gonna just help me to go all the way around. You don't have to worry about on this phone because the back is made out of plastic. Even so, it looks like glass, but this back is made out of plastic, so you can just be a little rough and you don't have to be afraid of breaking anything. Also, it don't have any cable attached to it, so don't worry about breaking any cable on the back because there is none. Just go around with the pry tool just like so and that back will come out very, very good. Let's keep on going and boom. There you go, the back just came out, and let's just keep going, put that on the side. Now then, the back is out of the way, I'm going to grab my Phillips screwdriver, and we're going to work on the screws holding down the middle frame on this phone. Let's get that done. Before removing the middle frame, let's remove the SIM card. The SIM card is going to be on our way and we can break something if we don't remove it. So make sure removing the SIM tray. Here, this phone can have a SIM card and also holds a micro SD card for more space. You can add more space to this phone. Alright, let's put it on the side and let's keep going. I'm going to grab my razor blade. Again, if you're not comfortable using this, use a guitar pick for this. I'm going to get in between the middle frame and the screen. Just going to pry it off this middle frame. It's just held by clips now that we removed all the screws. I'm gonna go all the way around, just like so. Just look at it. We're gonna be extra careful by where the buttons are. We have a few cables that we don't want to damage. After fighting a little bit with the middle frame, it's eventually just gonna come off. Just be careful, don't pull it at once because I have a few cables and just like see, one of the little cameras just flew off. Let's just put it back into the phone. I was pretty fast removing that back middle frame, so I didn't have a chance to show you that they has this little cable right here. Be careful not to break it. That happened to be the sensor for the fingerprint more than the power button, so make sure just not to break this little cable. Be extra careful right there. Put the middle frame on the side. This is getting really exciting as we get deeper and deeper into this repair. Now we have to transfer all these parts into the new screen. Let's start by just unplugging the battery. Do not use metal. Try to avoid metal. I use my nails because I got long nails, but use some plastic tools for this. All right, we have two screws, one for the charging port on the bottom and one for the motherboard on the top. So I'm gonna remove those two. This big cable in the middle connects the motherboard to the charging port and the LCD. We're gonna unplug the cable that connects with the LCD. And now we can remove this motherboard and the charging port in one piece, just like so. But first we need to pry it off. Actually, it's just a glue down this LCD cable. It's kind of folded and glued into the charging port, just like this. I usually avoid unplugging this cable from the motherboard because these cables get damaged really easy. Then we get into more trouble. Now we're gonna work in the battery. It has this plastic that wraps the battery around. It's a kind of easy hard remove, I could say, because it's not so easy. But it's not like before. The battery used to be glued down directly into the frame. Now they use this wrap that holds the battery, and after that, behind the wrap, it's the stronger adhesive. So we're gonna peel off this wrap, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull this blue tab, and the battery should come off easy. That's how the book says, but things not always go how the book said. So we're gonna use I'm gonna use my pry tool just to like give that little push into the battery, just like kind of lift the battery a little bit from one side to the other side. And now I'm going to try again to pull it. I'm gonna use my palm to hold the phone down, and with my thumbs, I'm gonna just pull the battery really hard, and it will just come out just looking beautiful, looking beautiful. The less damage you do to the battery during the removal, the better. That's how it's gonna supposed to look. And now this wrap, we can just grab it, peel it off, and transfer it to the new screen. That's gonna be a safe way to install our battery back in the new screen. And this is how it's gonna look, ready for the battery to be installed. Always check both of the screens to hunt for small components that we need to transfer from one to the other one. In this case, we have the ear speaker and the new screen, and also we have the side buttons, so we don't need to transfer. The only thing we're gonna transfer is the vibrator, which is right here, and we just pry it off with our screwdriver, and we just gonna glue it back into the new screen. We're gonna cover the dust protector right there, and also I'm gonna grab this little adhesive. This one goes on the back of the LCD connector, which is, remember, is fold and glue into the charging port. Just put it right there. It's all the little pieces that we can use. We're gonna use them to make our screen look and also work just the same. There's not a problem right here. Okay, we compare, and all the little parts that we need are in place. Now we're gonna grab our battery again and just fold it, and just like it was, and between that wrap and just close the wrap. That's gonna hold the battery on place. It's not gonna move after this. All right, we are looking really good into this repair. Shake it, make sure the battery don't fall off by itself. And just like so, you can judge by yourself if the battery is well installed. All right, next we have the whole component, the whole main piece of this phone, this puzzle at the motherboard. I'm just gonna lay it down flat on the new screen. And remember, this motherboard is gonna be held by one single screw, and the cable, which is this cable used for signal. Make sure you have these cables connected well into the motherboard and also the charging port. If one of these cables is not plugged in correctly, the you are going to have signal problems. So make sure it's connected. Right here we have the LCD connector. Remember, it has adhesive just folded and glued into the charging port. Then connect the cable to the LCD. Right there, it's gonna close. Remember, we have one screw holding down this charging port. Let's secure it. Then let's go to the top and do the same with the motherboard. One screw to secure the motherboard. All right, it's time to connect the battery. Connect the battery. Let's bring the middle frame, connect the power cable, fingerprint, and this occasion is gonna be a fingerprint, not power button. All right, let's just squish these two pieces together. Make sure they're closed fine, all the clips clip, and at this point we can peel off the protector film and turn on this phone. All right, we can check this phone before we finish this repair. Now that the phone is on, we can test all the features or maybe touch every corner of the screen, making sure there is no dead pixels or there is no keys on the keyboard that are not working. It could happen, maybe one key is not working, it will ruin our day. We can actually not use our phone. After making sure all this is well, all we have left is put all the screws back on place. All the screws are in place. Let's install back our SIM card. Just slide it inside there, make sure. So that will give us signal and actually we can make calls with that. If you don't install your SIM card, you're not gonna be able to make calls. All right, all we have left is install the back plate. Let's check on the adhesive. If your adhesive got damaged, we can replace it for a new one, but just check around. Usually this adhesive, it's very strong. What we can do also is remove the pieces that got damaged, keep the other pieces, and anyways, we're gonna help ourselves. We're gonna put some B7000. This is the glue that I usually use to install back glasses, and it's really nice, and I don't damage the phone. You know, you gotta find all the tools that you need, and this one is really good. I always use it. But anyways, we're gonna apply a little bit on the back right here, where the same place where the adhesive is. So you don't need to apply in different areas, because that way you can damage. Obviously, just make sure don't apply by the camera. You don't want to block the camera. And let's just apply this. Yeah, all the way around. Especially in the areas where the adhesive got damaged. There we go. I think that's good enough. That's good enough. Don't apply too much too, because another way, when you squish that back into the frame, you don't want adhesive like coming out. I don't like the look of it, so I try to just flat the adhesive, then I apply it with my tweezers, just like so. There is no excessive of this B7000 glue. So let's just make sure there's nothing in between there, like a screw or something, and just throw the back on the top of the phone. I mean the back in this case, and squish it and just push it. Make sure it's flat. If you see any bump, it will be area of concern. So make sure nothing was in between these two pieces. So, yeah, that's what I do. I just grab a little towel and that make just easier to kind of like push it down. Make sure all the areas are flat. Yeah, I always check around. Make sure the phone, put the phone like an angle. So that way you can see. If any bump, you can work on that area. Just basically done on this repair right here. You can always use some clamps and let it dry 10 to 20 minutes. That's it for this video, guys. I hope this video helped you to repair your Samsung Galaxy A15 5G. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to receive notification on future videos. Thank you so much for watching. This video is over. Bye now.